Oh, my name is Paul Pesach Pascovati. Most of the congregation knows me. I'm a new member of the board, and I would like today to give a little view on the parsha of Chukas, to give a little of Dvar Torah of the parsha of Chukas, and I'll take a very famous spot, of course, of that parsha. Well, all the spots are famous, but especially this one. When the Moses hits the rock, but I provide explanations that not, in my opinion, that widely known, why Moses hits the rocks and what I think about the whole situation. So, as we see from the book, and I have to apologize, I don't speak Hebrew, as we see from the book, when it starts, it says there, I'm going to quote, the children of Israel, the whole assembly arrived at the wilderness of Zin, and we know what happens. They complain that they don't have water, they have to go back, and Moses and Aaron talk go to the tent of meeting, talk to Hashem, and Hashem said, take your staff and talk to the rock to give the water. And what's interesting after that, if I read, Moses took the staff from before Hashem as he had commanded him. Moses and Aaron gathered the congregation before the rock and said to them. You probably noticed the difference, probably not. Interesting difference is that when the Israelites, when us, we arrived to that place, we arrived as assembly. But now Moses talked to us as the congregation. So what's the difference? And that's the keys, in my opinion, why the Moses hit the rock versus actually talking to the rock. Congregation, we all know we have a congregation of Turn Hill Community Shul, but we don't have an assembly of Turn Hill Community Shul. We have an assembly when assembly gets in a parliament, for example, when assembly gets in a Knesset. The assembly is much higher level of people being on a much higher level and much higher to attention, more formal and more, I would say, the more formal and more specific and more high level people. Whereas congregation could be congregation of friends. The people get together, people as friends get together, and the people just congregate, as we say. So the big difference here is that when you stand and what's happening, Moses basically saying, I don't want to deal with congregation. You're not worthy of the God, so I'm not going to listen to you, to the words of God. And I'm just going to hit the rock because I want to stay in front of assembly. I want to stay in front of the very high-level people that realize that they're standing in front of God, and God for them is such a higher being that they're very, very, very respectful of God. But instead, I'm staying in front of congregation, so people just, you know, fooling around. I'm not really happy. I'm not really sure. And because of it, I don't want to deliver that that congregation to the land of Israel. And under emotion, Moses hit the rock because he doesn't think that the level that he presents talking to the rock is for this congregation. It should be for assembly. And that's, we learn very, very important lesson from it. When we speak to the God or when we're doing something godly, we always have to be very, very formal. We have to behave as assembly, as very important people, versus just behaving as the group of friends or anything. If you notice, it's in our tradition for Shabbat to dress much more properly than every day. Most of the people will go in suits and ties, although it's not necessarily to be in a suit and tie. It's supposed to maybe supposed to dress pretty, but it's more formal. It's more assembly way. When you go to parliament, you also see everybody wearing suit and ties. So that's a very good lesson to us, saying that when we are staying in front of God and God tells us something, we have to be in assembly. We have to be a proper, formal people ready to receive God, not just congregations that God is some kind of our body and our friends that we're inviting him for a party. And I think that's a very important view of what happened with the rock. Thank you. Bye.